morning and welcome back to my channel. I haven't done a vlog for so long and I asked on Tuesday in our Facebook group, Luce's Ladies, whether you wanted me to do a vlog this week and a lot of you said yes. So I'm going to vlog me going to uni. So it's like 11:30 I think now and I've obviously just been in the shower, I've just got dressed. I'm not at uni until 2 o'clock. So I'm going to have my breakfast. I'm gonna have some lunch here. I've got some Subway salad, so I'm gonna make some wraps, like some chicken salad wraps with it. And then I'll probably take maybe the dog for a walk or something, get ready, and then we'll go to town. And I'm gonna go to uni first and meet with my friends, and then we're gonna go makeup shopping. Woohoo! I've got like two £30 Debenhams vouchers to use. So excuse like the state of my bedroom, by the way. It needs a real good sort out. So yeah, I'm hoping that I'm gonna get something from like Mac or somewhere like that to, stupid dog, to spend my two £30 vouchers on. I heard you jumping off the settee. So I've just made one like a monster wrap instead because it would have been like too many calories to have two wraps considering I don't really have much salad anyway. So I just thought I'll put it in one and then it's less calories for the wraps anyway. If our friend Rachel's watching this, she's going to be pissing herself laughing at how I wrap my wraps. But this is how I like it, okay? And then it's just from Subway. I had two yesterday out of it. So I doubled up on my chicken. So obviously you get to like two portions of chicken. And then I normally get like four wraps out of it, but I just decided to do one today. So normally I would get four, so I only got three this time. So I had two yesterday. I keep doing that with my nails, sorry. I had two yesterday and then obviously one today as well. So it's time to put some makeup on. So I'm just going to be using whatever's in my makeup bag. I might grab some other stuff from like my makeup drawers. But if you watched Wednesday's video, I'll leave it linked down below. I did a full what's in my makeup bag. I had everything that's in here. I just emptied it all out on my bed. So yeah, if you want to see that, then I will leave it linked down below for you. It's a really nice like chit-chatty video as well, so it's nice to be able to like sit back and actually like talk to you. So I'm gonna take the Pro Prime Aqua Priming Base and just spray this all over. I actually love this. I'm also like, when I'm doing my makeup now, I'm also prepping my makeup bag with everything that I'm going to need for when I go to Blake's house tonight, because I'll need my makeup obviously for tomorrow. And taking some of the strobe cream by Revolution as well, and then put this just a little bit on my forehead and on my cheeks, like so. And then just going to blend that out. It's like only the tiniest bit, but and I just find that it's really helping with my glow recently. Because I'm just going to uni, I'm going to apply the number 7 Stay Perfect foundation in the shade Calico. Before that, I'm going to go in with the Benefit Dew the Hoola moisturiser, no, bronzer. And I put this like kind of underneath my cheekbones kind of thing. And you can apply as much as you want with this because we're putting it under our foundation. But I only really apply like a little bit anyway, just to give me a little bit more of like a bronzy colour to my skin because I am so pale. And then I just take a tiny little bit, like a little tiny blob for my temples. Obviously I'm only going to uni, so I don't need to be like full glam. So I'm going to shake this up and then I always like to apply dots all over my face, and then just gonna dab this out with with my beauty blender. I've got an interview tomorrow. Well, it is an interview really. With like an old friend from school, like somebody that I went to school with, and she wants to interview me about like my YouTube stuff. So quite excited but a bit nervous about that at the same time. By the way, if you really like really really thin, can't feel that they're there foundations, you'll absolutely love this foundation. It is so thin. I just love it. It's definitely like a day-to-day foundation. I wouldn't wear this for a night out, but you know that anyway. And then taking some High Beam by Benefit, I'm going to put this on the top of my cheeks, a little bit on my forehead, and a little bit on my nose and cupid's bow as well. And then I take the beauty blender again to just dab this into place. Every time I think of dab, I just think of Millie now, because all she ever does is dab. Then taking some of the Collection Last Imperfection Concealer in, this will probably just be light, fair one. I'm just going to take a little bit just in the inside here, just to kind of brighten it up a little bit, but I don't want to bring it, like, normally I'd do like a triangle, but when I put high beam on already, and I only find that like it covers it up, so I'm just going to put a little bit on, because I was up until 2:30, 3 o'clock last night replying to YouTube emails that I've been like waiting to reply to since like February. That was very, very time consuming. And like, it's one of the things where like once you get into it, you think, I'm never gonna like, it's gonna be ages until I get back into this again. So I'll just get it done whilst I'm here. So yeah, that's why I got up so late. I've been up since like 10, but I've just been like chilling in bed for a bit. And taking my RCMA powder in the Morphe M438 brush, I'm gonna use this just to set that concealer before it creases. And then to set the rest of my face, I'm using, obviously, the MAC Studio Fix Powder Foundation in NC20 with the Real Techniques Powder Brush. And I'm just gonna really focus this like on the bottoms of my face here, because this is where my foundation always seems to come off. And then around my mouth, my nose. I am so excited to get my eyelashes done next week, by the way. If you saw in Wednesday's videos, I had like a little plaster on my hand, and basically what that was me getting the patch test to see if I can get my eyelashes, like LVL eyelashes kind of thing, and I haven't reacted to it, so that is like really, really good, because it means I can actually get my eyelashes done. Would you like me to record that when I get them done next week? There's like this amazing little beauty shop place. I just put some of the Nivea lip butter in Raspberry Rose on, by the way. But it's like this little beauty place in Gisborough called Charlie Jared. She has it on Facebook if you want to search it and you live like in Middlesbrough area. And that's who did my nails for me. So yeah, I was going to get my mum's friend to do it in her like salon place. And then I went and got my nails done by Charlie, and Charlie's absolutely lovely. I've had my nails done by her before, but just gels. And then obviously she's got this place in Gisborough now. So I am super, super excited to get my eyelashes done now that I haven't reacted. I'm just taking some of this Kat Von D bronzer, by the way. This is the shade Shadow Play. So yeah, I'm really, really excited to have her doing them for me. And my eyelashes have just been horrible recently. Like, they haven't been working as well as what they used to. Like, when I think back of my eyelashes when I worked like on Benefit and even on Galan as well, my eyelashes were just like amazing, like immense, and I used to get so many compliments on them. That's how I used to sell so many mascaras when I worked for Benefit, because my eyelashes, obviously I had Benefit's mascara on, and my eyelashes just like would just looked amazing. Like, I'm not even I know it sounds really big-headed, but my eyelashes were just so nice, and then I don't know what's happened to them. They've just gone really, really rubbish. So I'm hoping like the LVL will help like me love my eyelashes again, because no matter what mascara I try, whether it's like even the Benefit ones on me now, just don't do anything. Not compared to what they used to do anyway. So yeah, I'm excited to get that done. And it's like £30. My mum's getting hers done as well. And my friend Laura, we all went and got our patch test done yesterday. And none of us have reacted, thank God. But obviously I was really worried about reacting, because obviously I've reacted to get my brows done by Benefit before. I'm just taking, by the way, some of this shade here at the end, which is called Subconscious. And I'm just tapping my brush into it. And it's that fake NARS Eiter brush, which I got off eBay, so it's like £2 odd, I think. If you go on my website, www.lucestephenson.com, I've got a link to it there for you on the eBay brushes post. So yeah, I'm really, really excited. And it's like £30, but obviously you're getting it done, and it lasts 4 to 6 weeks. I'm going to take some of the Too Faced Shadow Insurance Primer Seeing as I'm filming today, I'll put a bit of eyeshadow on. To be fair, I have been wearing eyeshadow quite a lot recently for uni. Just been playing around so I can like start using up some of my makeup a bit more. Because I just feel like it was all like going to waste, if that makes sense. Because I've just got so much. But yeah, you get your eyelashes like permed, like so they go up and curly. So I'm going to get them like fanned out. So it looks super, super natural. Obviously, really, really long. And then after 4 weeks as well, you get a free tint. So you get to go back and get your eyelashes tinted again. So even if your eyelashes are starting to drop, they're still going to be really nice and black. I'm going to use my Chanexo palette, which is what I was raving about in my video on Wednesday. So I'm taking a little brush and this like pale shade here and using that to set all over the lid and right up to that brow bone. So this is the Chanexo and BH Cosmetics palette, in case you didn't know. I love it. I really need to go get my eyebrows done as well. So I'm thinking next week I might even book to get my hair done. Because in case you can't see, yeah, I've got a lot of roots that need sorting out. So I'm thinking, should I get my eyebrows done, my eyelashes done, and whilst I'm there, might as well book in and get my hair done next week as well. So I might see... and maybe have like next Wednesday as like my pamper day. So like I'll get my eyebrows done, my eyelashes done, and get my hair done as well. So I'll see if they can fit me in. So I'm taking a fluffy brush. I'm going to be taking this yellowy kind of shade here. And I'm just going to blend that in the crease. Then taking a smaller, fluffier brush, I'm going to go in with this like reddish browny colour. And put this like a bit lower in the crease than that would be. I'm not doing like a... crazy eye today, just putting a little something on, a little summer something, and then I'm just gonna take that underneath the eye a little bit as well. And then taking a flat, fluffy kind of brush, I'm gonna be using the shimmery shade in the top middle. I'm gonna apply that all over the lid. I think I'm just gonna leave it like that actually, and not deepen it up like I normally do. But I am gonna take some of the Galan eyeliner in the shade Jackie Brown, which I absolutely love. And I'm gonna put this just underneath. For blusher, I'm gonna go in with MAC Melba, and then my brush that I've been raving about recently. This is the Duo Fiber Face Brush. And I'm just gonna blend that onto the cheeks. Anybody else pulling out really funny faces when they're putting the blush on? To take my trusty friend, the Freedom Eyebrow Pomade in Ash Brown, and then my little and then my little eyebrow brush from eBay, I'm gonna do my brows. I think I'm gonna do it for like a natural brow day. Normally I do it a little bit more intense than this. Not on purpose, that's just how it kind of works out. Then I'm gonna take some of Benefit Gimme Brow and focus this on like the tail of my brow, and then I kind of go around to the front. It's like the most pigment and product is at the end. Makes sense. And that's where I'm like the most patchy with my brow as well, as right in the arch. So before I go in with highlighter and mascara, I'm going to apply some Set and Spray. This is the Makeup Revolution Pro Fix Makeup Set and Spray. Then I'm going to go in with highlighter. This is the Nicole Guerrero and Anastasia Beverly Hills highlighter palette. And I'm going to go in with a mixture of Glow Getter and 141. And then just a tap. That's it. Of Forever Lit, because that is... lit. The name is very fun. And then I'm going to take the Morphe B16 brush, and I'm going to take a little bit of Glow Getter, and then just tap Forever Lit, and I'm going to use this as my brow highlight. So for mascara, I'm going to go in with my eyelash curlers first, my Shimmer ones, and then I'm going to apply a little bit of, well, I'm going to apply a mixture of the two basically. Whenever I wear these kind of colours, so I've got like, this is my jumper in it, I've got a dress in this colour and also another top in this colour, I always wear Androgyny Lipstick by Jeffree Star, of course. Lighting looks so weird today, but yeah, I'm finally ready. Does my makeup look over here? Alright, finally ready. I've got Androgyny on my lips, in case I haven't already said. I think I have though. Yes, let's go. I'm going to take my big bag to sleep at Blake's house. And then I've just got my little backpack for uni. And I'll speak to you in the car.
After that lipstick bloody nightmare, I can finally set off to uni, bloody hell. So basically when I got to the car, I realised how much I'd overdrawn my lips at home and how like ridiculous it looked. So I ended up like sitting in my car and completely removing all of my lipstick and then reapplying it again. I found that like, I don't know if anybody else has this problem who has like really thin lips. When you try to overline your lips, because I have like pores around my lips, obviously everybody does, but because I have pores around my lips, when I try to overline them, it looks like dotty sometimes, if that makes sense. I don't know. It really does my head in because then it just doesn't look crisp and like a really good line of your lips. This is like the best I'm gonna get. I'm gonna have to like touch up it up with like some makeup or something. But I can't be bothered actually. I'm gonna pick up the, I don't think I've got any sun gigs in my bag. I'm gonna, God, what an absolute moron. Someone just like came flying under the road on the bike. Doyles. But yeah, I'm gonna try and get the 17 stick foundation I had. Somebody messaged me on Snapchat. Oh my God, I can't remember her name. It always comes blank to me when like I'm talking about it to like the camera. Can't remember who it was. I'm sure it was Darcy. Is it Darcy? I'm sure it started with a D, and I'm sure the only person that I really speak to on there like consistently is Darcy. Is it Darcy? I hope so. But yeah, she recommended for me to get the 17 foundation sticks, so that they're really, really good. She like got them that day and tried it and was really impressed. So I'm thinking I'm gonna get them, and she's, I'm sure she said that they were $2.99 or $3.99. I'm sure she said $2.99 though. How cheap is that? So yeah, I'll show you if I do buy anything today. I'll show you, I'll do like a little haul in my car after uni or something, because once I get to Blake's house tonight, I won't be recording anything because that's mine and his time. Can you see my highlight? Is it blinded? Is it blinded? I love this Nicole Guerrero set. Like, it is just absolutely stunning. I don't think it's for those people who want like a subtle natural glow, like it's for people that want to be like bam in your face, look at the highlight kind of thing. So yeah, I'd recommend picking it up whilst it's still available. I don't know if it's limited edition. That's quite interesting to know. I don't think they've ever mentioned that it's limited edition. So, and it wasn't like it sold out straight away, because I ordered it from the UK website, so I don't know. It cost me £39, I think, and then free postage because I'd like spent over a certain amount. So, and it came like super, super quick. Like a big gap in the road there. Yeah, it came super, super quick, so I'm very, very impressed. But yeah, I'll speak to you when I get to uni or something, or when I'm going to the shops, because I think this video is going to be very, very long because I've already like done a full like video on my makeup today. So
check it.
Oh my gosh.
What colour is it? It's matte as well, isn't it? It looks a bit shimmery. Or is it just the packaging?
Oh no, if it's shimmery, I'm not getting it.
Might just be the packaging that's shimmery though. That's not going to dry matte that though, you know.
No.
It's going to be like a lipstick.
No, shimmery looks cheaper.
If you look like it, yeah.
Ooh, it's a little bit dark for me to be filming here, but I'm going to anyway. So, last time I spoke to you, or the last clip you left off, was probably me having food. That food was absolutely disgusting, by the way. I got like a chicken meal baguette with some chips, and the baguette was like rock hard, and I just thought, for how many carbs and how many calories this baguette is going to be for me, it is not worth it at all. So I just sacked it off, and the chips are just like eating air. Like, there was like no like potato in it. It was just like, oh, it was just not good at all. So yeah, I just completely sacked that food off.
And then we went to MAC. It was just me and Mitzi, who was like the blonde girl in the video, in case you paid attention to that. Ooh, that was such a tight squeeze then. Me and her ended up going over to Debenhams, and she got like colour matched up at Benefit for foundation and got a sample of it, and she bought the new Benefit lipsticks as well, like the little four set of lipsticks that come in the little box. She got that. Roll it, my girl. Are you coming or not? That was just weird. I don't get why that happened there, but okay then. And then we went over to MAC, and I found, like, not found, but like, was speaking to like the loveliest person ever in MAC. I actually didn't get a name, but she was so nice. And like, she was just showing us all like these different things that you could do, and like, I don't know, she gave us some samples as well, and she told us about like the makeovers that you can get at MAC. So I was going to spend, I've got like two £30 vouchers that I was talking to you about, so I was going to spend that at MAC today anyway, but I didn't really know what to get. So I thought, well, I might as well just use them vouchers to get a makeover where like you pay like, and like £50 and you get shown like how to do it all, but then you also get the £50 to spend on makeup as well. So I would have been paying for the makeup anyway, but I'm basically getting like a free makeover with it as well, so I'm going to do that. I think I'm going to do it for like when I've got a night out coming up on like in April time, like mid-April, going like out for like a night out at uni, so hopefully I'll be able to get booked in for that and get my makeup done all nice and pretty. So I was just like in the library, so we obviously went to class 4 till 6, and I couldn't obviously record in class, so I couldn't vlog that bit. And then we ended up going to the library just to like chill for a bit, because we finished class at 6, so like the road's always chocker, so we always like stay back a little bit just to like wait until the traffic dies down and then set off, because we don't want to be stuck in traffic anyway. So I'm just setting off now, and it's like 7 o'clock, I'm just setting off to my mum's house. I was gonna go to Blake's, like what I said earlier, but I like texted him and I was like, oh, I'm like coming to yours now, and he was like, oh, completely forgot, I'm at rugby training. So he's gone to rugby training, but he doesn't get home until about 8:30 at night, and I thought, oh, I can't be bothered like coming to your house so late, and then by the time you get back and then get showered and stuff, and we're both getting up early and leaving tomorrow morning like separately, so I just thought there's no point, so I'll just go to his tomorrow, and I'll get some uni work done tonight, because obviously I got an extension for my like ICA, like one of my assignments was due on Tuesday just gone, and I've got an extension for that, so it's not due in until this Tuesday coming up. I've got like a week's extension, so at least I can like get a head start with that, whereas if I went to Blake's house, I don't have my laptop or anything with me, like waiting for him to get home kind of thing. So yeah, I'll just I'm gonna go up to my mum's house and get some uni work done tonight, but just because I feel like going shopping, even though I've been shopping all day. I didn't actually buy anything, by the way. I tried to get that 17 stick foundation that Darcy was telling me about on Snapchat, and I couldn't find it. They didn't even have it in stock at all. Like, it wasn't even like there was a gap missing in my boots, like as if like it was all sold out or whatever. So I don't really know whether like our boots, excuse me, hiccup. I don't know whether our boots have got it in yet. But I'll probably be going to another boots over where I'm going with my mum in a minute. I'll probably end up going to the boots there, so I'll see if they've got it in stock there, but I have a feeling that they probably won't, to be honest. So I tried to get the L'Oreal infallible sponge as well, because Casey Holmes raves about it, saying how good it is, and it hasn't actually came out yet, but they had it on the counters as like a gift if you bought like 6 products, but like the products were on 3 for 2, so really you were buying like 4 products. Yeah, I was like, I'm not buying like 6 products just for me to get the sponge for free. I'll just wait until it comes out and buy it for like $6.99, otherwise I'd just be wasting a lot of money just to get the one sponge that I wanted. So yeah, I'll try that another time. So yeah, I rang my mum then, and I was like, what are you doing? And she's like, oh, I'm just picking Millie up went to pick Millie up from dancing, and I was like, oh, okay. I was like, do you want to go to Matterland and go to the shops? And she was like, yeah. It isn't closed. Like, Matterland doesn't close till 9, we think. And Matterland always closes a bit later than the other shops, and then the other shops close at 8, so it's only like a little like drive down the road from us. So we'll go there, and I might even get a Costa if we have a chance, if we have time before it closes. We get like a, I don't know, like a hot chocolate or something. I don't know. I'll see. Sometimes it's just not worth the calories at all. So I don't know whether to wait here for my mum. State of my makeup now. But you can tell that I've been makeup shopping. Yeah, I don't know whether to just wait on the front for my mum or... Oh, put that light back on. Look at that glow. Yes. Yes, honey. Yes. Yeah, I don't know whether to wait here for my mum or to go in. I think I have to go in because I think I'm going to wee myself. So I think it's fair to say I'm not very good at this vlogging game. I went to the shops with my mum and she like returned some tops. I went into the boots and they didn't have that 17 foundation sticker there either. So I'm going to have to see if I can get it online, or if it's like a release date or something that I'm like missing or whatever, because obviously it's not on that one either. I've literally just got off the phone to like a Facebook FaceTime thing with my friend for 4 hours and 33 minutes. I was talking to my friend Hobbs for, how crazy is that, 4 hours and 33 minutes. I'm gonna watch the video that I was watching before we did that, which is a what I eat in a day to lose weight and healthy grocery haul. I'm gonna watch the rest of that and then get myself to sleep because it is 20 to 2 and I thought I was gonna have an early night, but I'm also going to sleep with my makeup on because I took my pill and I've took my contacts out and it's time to sleep. I've got an interview tomorrow for my YouTube, like from a friend from uni. I think I mentioned it earlier on, but a friend from uni wants, no, a friend from school wants to interview me about my YouTube setup and all that kind of stuff. So I'm meeting her, I think, at 10 o'clock in the morning, but I've asked her if she wants it to be a bit later because she's travelling quite far, so... just thought it might be nicer for her. So yeah, I've got that tomorrow, so I'll hopefully speak to you on Sunday's video, which is going to be a testing sleek makeup look. So if you liked the makeup in Wednesday's video on my what's in my makeup bag video, then that's the makeup look that will be in Sunday's video. Thank you so much for watching, I love you all very much, and yeah, sorry that I'm not very good at this vlogging game.